like sports coat. Quarterback of the Bears. Fighting into a problem. Steamboat on Keller Brooks. I'm joined by Chris Adams again this week. Chris, you're looking good again this week.
Thank you very much, Mark. You know, I am so excited to be back here at World Class. You know, this is my home away from home. And new things are happening in World Class. New things, exciting things. Kerry Von Erich's back. You know, the Von Erichs are as strong as ever. I'm coming back.
He's fantastic. Champion. That's you why know, they call him the killer.
It's funny, but it slipped my mind before, but I forgot to mention that slimy, no good, cunning, you know who I'm talking about, don't you, Mark? Gary Hart.
Who else?
Who else? And he has Al Perez, which is a very, very capable and very, very good world champion. So, of course, you know, my eyes are set on that world championship. I did have it once. You know, I didn't lose it, and I aim to get that back again. But I know Kerry's after it, and I know Kevin's after it. It's going to be tough. And World Class, as you know, is doing something very, very special. We are going out on a one-time-only basis to all the major cities all over the United States. So I can't wait. It's something new, and World Class is back as strong as ever. And it's fantastic, Mark. I'm very excited about it.
Chris, let's go back to last week when Playboy Vince Apollo was very instrumental in helping Gary Hart turn the tables of the wrestling match for the World Heavyweight Wrestling title between Al Perez and Superman Tony Atlas. Are we going to see a relationship between Apollo and Gary Hart?
I don't know exactly what Apollo's doing. He thinks he's, like I say, he thinks he's Jack the Lad. He comes down to the ring in his flashy coat. He brings his Louis Vuitton, you know, little notebook and his Parker pen, and he thinks he's just, you know, God's gift. But I really don't know what he's up to, and I don't know what Gary Hart's up to, although I do know what Gary Hart is like. And if I know Gary Hart, he's up to something very cunning, and it'll probably involve Al Perez, who also is a very cocky individual who thinks that every woman thinks that, you know, I guess he came from the stars.
Brooks with a drive on Vic Speedball.
You know what I find very interesting? We've got lots of new talent coming to World Class. New talent, new ideas, new concepts, and a new World Class. It makes me feel really happy and good to be back home.
Rick Steamboat fighting back on Kenneth Brooks and Percy Pringle protesting from the inside. Say, all you Von Erich fans, be sure to pick up your copy of the Von Erich Family Album, available in your local bookstores across the country. That's the Von Erich Family Album, available in your local bookstores in your community. Roughhouser Brooks moving in. Chris, you've had experience. You've been in the ring with Brooks. You've watched him over the years. He's really tough.
Now, Brooks isn't the most organized wrestler, but that's what makes him so dangerous. You see, he's a roughhouse. I mean, he's a bar fighter. He's a bar brawler. You know, you never know where Brooks is going to come from. You never know what he's going to do. And I'll tell you one thing. If he gets the upper hand, then you might as well forget it. But on the other hand here now, Steamboat. Now, you know that he's a very, very famous man. A very, very well-known wrestler all over the world. And I know that Steamboat is relatively new in the business. But you mark my words, he's just like Sean Simpson in a few, I'd say even months. I know he's going to be one of the top young stars also in this country.
Gentlemen, Chris Adams articulating his feelings here with us. Yeah! Steamboat has taken into the corner.
I like that, Mark.
You like those big words.
I like it when you come out with those big words.
But I don't know what I'm talking about. I always make up big words. Brooks, ready to pick up Steamboat again. We want to say hello to this week to WMCC in Indianapolis, a world-class network affiliate. There's Brooks thrown into the corner. Looks like he hit his head in the steel post. Well, your old buddy Percy Pringle's looking dapper this week.
He looks real dapper. He looks like he just fell out of the sky. You know, Percy Pringle, he's another one, you know, Gary Hart, Percy Pringle, put them all in the same category, and now it looks like Vince Apollo is going to join them. I don't know. I don't know what's going on, but you know what, Mark? I have mentioned before, but I also have a little surprise.
Here's Steamboat with a drive. What is your surprise?
You know, Mark, if I told you what my surprise was, then
it
wouldn't be a surprise.
Hey, look, the truck's up on the road. Oh, brother.
Yeah!
The ball will not count.
Nobody saw that, Brooks. It's okay.
That's what you call smart.
Here's the three. I know it. Two, three.
You're right. Steamboat comes back. Let's go to Ralph Pulley, then we'll finish up, Chris. Tell us, Ralph. Now, we were talking about your surprise. You won't tell us?
I really can't tell you the surprise, but all I'm saying is watch out, Gary Hart. Watch out, Percy Pringle. And watch out, Vince Apollo.
All right, we'll be back for more world-class wrestling excitement from the sport of joy, man, from the Cotton Bowl. We'll talk about a class tour, first time ever.